it's puzzling. I don't think I've ever seen anything quite like this before.
Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise. Its continuing mission to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no one has gone before.
Captain's log, stardate 48348.3. We have arrived at motherfucking Space Slam! For those of you that don't know me, my name is Anton Luc Picard, and I am the link to the next generation. And this is our second Space Slam. We did this a year ago, and it was fucking awesome. So we decided, let's do this shit yearly.
Trouble with Tribbles, am I right?
Oh, you're right, sir. With your Star Trek reference, you're right. It wasn't like Next Generation, but yeah, but it's still a good joke, good joke, good joke. So, I decided to park the Starship Enterprise right above the Oakland Metro Opera House for the time being. Because as soon as this show starts, we are going to tractor beam this whole fucking building into the fucking cosmos! So if you guys need to go outside for a smoke break, be fucking careful, because it's space. It's cold as fuck. I've seen space-related movies. It's cold out there. Except for in Star Wars when Leia, like, flew through... Whatever. It doesn't matter. It doesn't fucking matter! Thank you all so much for coming, and I will not be doing this hosting and commentating alone. Holy shit, hold on to your butts. Because my co-host and co-commentator... I'm just gonna let this whole shit speak for itself. Come on out here! Holy shit, Paul, turn the goddamn music off! Jesus Christ! In the words of the great American author John Steinbeck, there that is. Thank you, Wonder Dave, so much for joining me here tonight. Actually, I feel like I'm joining you. I feel like I'm joining you here tonight, so thank you for having me.
Thanks for being here.
Hey. I'm broken again.
Where's the show gonna go from here? We've already done the two most obvious things people think of when they think space!
Yeah! You and me! That's it! You know, she's probably busy being an admiral or something, I think. If I know my Star Trek lore, which I do. By the way, lore is a Star Trek character. He was the brother of Data. BAM!
Yeah, that was correct.
Fucking nailed it. So yeah, we have some craziness, Wonder Dave. What can we expect to see here tonight? In the words of another great American author, R.L. Stein, you fucking got that right, Wonder Days.
Yeah!
Fuck the fans.
You look like so many men I've had sex with already. Like, just... I mean, listen, I am pretty drunk at the end of the show usually, so... Holler at a bitch.
So standards are high, is what he's saying. So, fuck it, why don't we just get into the thing? Why don't you do the point and the thing, and then we'll just move on with the show.
We tell people the things?
Yeah, the things.
Hey, guys, there's rules. Rule number one, don't bring your fucking kids. We don't want them. No kids. No kids.
It's 21 and up, so if you tucked them into your fucking shirt or something, take them outside into space and chuck them into the fucking abyss, you know?
Put them in the spaceship, roll the window down, they'll be fine.
That's how space works.
What? Hey, rule number two, don't throw shit.
Don't throw shit.
No throwing shit in the ring unless...
One exception. You can throw your paper dollars all over the ring. Please.
Yeah. If you're liking a match or something, you see it.
You know what? If you're not liking a match, throw money at it. Maybe it'll get better. Who knows?
It's happened before. Oh, hey! Yeah! I cannot bend over to pick those up.
I can! Rule number three, you all have drinks in your hand for the most part. Don't put them on the fucking ring, please. This makes fucking movement, and your drink will spill over, and then someone will flip upon their neck and die.
You're a fucking murderer. You're a murderer. You're laughing at that shit. Is sad.
So don't set your drinks on the fucking ring, please. Don't touch the ropes. You guys with your hands on the apron, that's fine with that, unless there's someone out there. Speaking of someone coming out there, if someone in this section hands up this section, if someone seems like they're gonna spill out, get the fuck out of their way, because someone's probably gonna jump upon them. And unless you want to help catch that person, which you shouldn't, because that person will probably fucking choke you. Yeah, right. Yeah, he gets it. This guy gets it. So just get out of the way if someone's getting too close to you. Pat, how are you feeling?
I'm here.
Okay, Pat's good. I'm ready to go.
Good. Matt?
Yeah.
Should I get them properly?
Yeah, yeah, let's do it. Yeah. Yeah.
Show.
Okay! I'll let you out now, Rainbow Pop-Tart Cat, whose name I forgot.
Nyan
Cat. Yeah. So, as you can see by the the rocket smoke on the stage, we have blasted off into orbit. Welcome to space, everybody. I totally forgot that I was supposed to wait for some referees before we took off, so we don't have any. Luckily, the Starship Enterprise can beam over one of my ensigns to be our referee for this evening, Ensign Wiggles!
Ensign Wiggles!
Ensign! They said, fuck you, Wiggles. Make it so.
Let's get our first match underway. Introducing first. That guy's gonna get tired before the night's over. Are from. This is, you guessed it, Predator! A race of half insect, half fucking cannibal like creatures whose only goal is to hunt and kill the most elusive and difficult prey. That mask has cybernetics in it, lets him know like who the target is and shit. And he's looking over here. Luckily I have my Romulan cloaking device. Can't see me. I made the rules just now. Predator. Sees in heat vision while wearing the mask. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Hey! Whoa, Predator! Leave Jada alone! She's not a part of the show!
Oh, no! That's just a nice security guard.
That's not your opponent!
Metro. She's just a woman doing her job.
Wait a minute! From a salvage ship from the planet Earth, this is Ellen Ripley!
Ellen Ripley, star of the Alien movie franchise, of course. Now, Aliens and Predator have crossed over, oh. The crowd already rallying behind Ripley.
Whoa! And this one's underway!
Oh shit, ring that bell!
Oh, it's great, right? Yeah.
Oh, Ripley throws a forearm!
Whoa, attacking at the mask!
Another forearm from Ripley, the Predator.
Oh, runs right into a space boot.
Oh, a space boot. And a space head scissors.
Hell yeah. On just about every top 10 badass movie characters you will see, Ellen Ripley near or at the top. And the Predator slowly stalking back into the ring. And oh! I don't care what planet you're from, that means fuck you! And Ripley now ascending to the ropes and raining down punches to the Predator! And this has been all Ripley, the Predator. Maybe this is like the runt of the litter of Predators.
Or maybe Ellen Ripley is just that good.
Irish whip, uh-oh, reversed. Shot to the midsection. Oh!
Oh! Stop.
Right
Sweet
off
Predator
the,
music.
Yep, right off of the forehead of Ripley. And holy shit, I don't care if she's got alien DNA or whatever. She has gotten fucked up so far. And Predator now just grinding Ripley upon the ropes. Could be trying to collect a trophy.
Got some cash flying in the ring.
And Ripley, lucky to avoid getting her face sliced open. There is a quick forearm to that Predator. Irish whip gets reversed, and Ripley eats the buckle hard. Predator, oh shit! Double knees in the corner, heads up! Oh my god! Huge fucking cannonball!
One white guy with a beard chanting for Predators.
And the Predator removing the mask. No longer seeing in heat vision, but seeing probably like 80% better in real life. Oh, and a huge shot across the scapulae of Ripley. Grabbing her by the hair, the like 70 pounds of hair.
Scoops her up and slams her down to the mat, and Ellen Ripley is in a world of hurt right now.
Oh yeah, those mom jeans are feeling it right now.
Those mom jeans are back in style?
Finally. Oh no. The Predator.
Oh, Predator goes for the moonsault, but nobody's home.
And this could be Ripley's opportunity. Comes in, sweeps the leg, rolls through. And a huge fucking splash. And the Predator is down, maybe out. Only two, says Ensign Wiggles. Oh, that's not nice. He's doing his job. A job I pay him to do. And Ripley grabbing the Predator, but Predator having none of it. Huge chop across the chest. Uh-oh, could be going for a Blue Thunder bomb. And Ripley down. And a lack of respect from the Predator. Which is weird, because Predators are known for their respect if I watch the right movie.
No, but they do love iced tea. Wait, what? That's To Catch a Predator. That's a bad joke.
Huge forearm to the face. Irish whip. Ducks the claw. Into a huge fucking DDT. And the Predator just got dropped right on its fucking skull bone. Ellen Ripley starting to stir, but definitely feeling the fucking after effects of that brutal assault by the Predator. Ripley now, Irish whip, reversed. Ducks the clothesline, scoops her up into a huge tilt-a-whirl head scissor.
Goes for the cover.
Again.
Two says Ensign Wiggles.
After that mighty barrage of offense, dropping the Predator once again right on the top of his head. But the Predator must have some kind of thick alien skull. Going for it again. But no. Oh, Predator!
Oh, no!
Chomping at the finger! Russian leg sweep! Oh, no! Watch out!
Oh!
And a huge senton! Dropping all of those whatever aliens weigh themselves with across the body of Ripley. Predator now, again scooping her up, and drops her with another big fucking bomb.
Gets the shoulder up just in time.
Ripley survived multiple alien movies, and then even when she died was like, "Nah, I'll do the next one, it's fine." Because you can't keep down Sigourney Weaver. And now, Predator looks to be ascending the turnbuckles here. Just like in Predator 2 when he was like climbing around on buildings and shit.
Predator up on the top rope. Alan Ripley down in the center of the ring.
Oh! And Predator spitting that viscous fluid.
Oh! I know about Predator anatomy, but that looks like it fucking hurts.
Right in the fucking cloaca of the Predator.
Ah, cloacas.
Yeah. That's a word I've heard before.
It's a bird vagina and or male bird vagina.
Ooh. And Ripley seems to be going for some kind of superplex. But Predator's like, nah. No! Headbutt to the head. But Ripley is getting up. Nailed it.
Predator collecting himself after that nut shot on the ropes. I'm sorry, cloaca shot.
Yeah, cloaca. I've decided that's a part of his anatomy.
It's canon now, baby.
Predator stalking its prey. Oh, psyched her out.
Oh, stomps to the midsection of Ripley.
No, that was pretty legal. Although the laws and rules of space are highly debated. It's like maritime law. No! Predator hits the turnbuckle hard, and Ripley now. And a huge shot to the face. And Predator now pulling Ripley up by her head. Could be going to bring her in the hard way. But Ripley with some shots to the stomach. Into a huge fucking face buster.
Put him in a body bag.
Yeah, Johnny, put him in a body bag.
Got to the chest of Predator. Predator's got Ripley in a headlock. Looks like he's... Oh!
Oh! Yep. Holy shit! I'm not sure who got the pinfall. Ripley wins it! Holy shit!
Apparently the shoulders of the Predator were down. I saw Ripley's shoulder was up.
And the Predator is not fucking happy about it.
The Predator shoving Ensign Wiggles out of the way.
Predator, the only one on their feet, but did not come away with the victory tonight. Gonna have to go home to Predatoria, or wherever the fuck he's from. Tell all the other Predators, tonight was not their night. But your winner, Ripley!
Hey there, folks out in the audience. I see a lot of you have your cameras out. Please remember to tag @SexyGoodTimeFTF on all social media.
Hell yeah. Or #SexyGoodTime, #HoodSlam. You know, we'll find it. Just post it and tag us and it'll be awesome. Thank you so much.
We love it.
So let's keep this rolling on. The following contest is scheduled for one fall. What's that? Oh, excuse me, I'm getting something over my headset. What's that, Hal? 4,000? Oh shit, really? Everyone, I've just been informed that luckily we blasted off from Oakland and into space, but there is a giant fucking asteroid heading straight for the Bay Area!
Oh, a giant fucking asteroid! Who will save us?
I will keep you all informed with how that's going along. It's pretty far away, but I will keep you all up to date. But that is some news. Yeah, hold on, Hal. Yeah, Hal, keep me informed. Yeah, I told them that you would keep me informed, so now you have to. Those are the rules of the headset. Okay, thank you. I'll keep you all informed. Woo! Let's get on with this next contest. Introducing first.
Representing Mother Russia.
Will ever endure the great Soviet Union to create a dream of a fortress to shore. Long live a Soviet motherland.
He's the first human being in space escorted to the ring by the first animal in space. It's Yuri Gagarin and Laika the dog!
Got a satellite with him. Is that Sputnik?
Sputnik!
In Soviet Russia, balloon is fucking satellite.
In Russia, we don't have satellites. We have balloons.
And Yuri, in there waving that gigantic red flag like every single one of my ex-girlfriends did.
It's really nice of them to break that red flag.
It would help. What do you need?
You're
oh, yeah.
Microphone.
Sure, yeah.
All right.
Play it again. Looks like Yuri wants to say something.
Uh-oh. How's it going?
There's an asteroid headed for your planet. Fuck yeah! That's the right response.
The good news?
I don't remember Yuri saving anyone from an asteroid.
He was the first man in space.
He could probably save us from an asteroid.
Oh, shit. Hang on. Hang on. I know who can save us from an asteroid. Just make Steven Tyler noises like everyone else. Surrender! Oh shit! From the planet Earth and the good old USA, it's Bruce Willis from Armageddon! You, babe, you don't wanna miss a thing.
And dreaming is
a dream of you, sweetest dream we'll ever do. I still miss you, babe. I don't wanna miss a thing. Oh, slap, 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 slap. And Bruce Willis from Armageddon, pointing in slow motion.
Willis,
slow
motion. You will be calling out.
Don't wanna close my eyes. Don't wanna fall asleep, 'cause I miss you, babe. I don't wanna miss a thing.
Even when I dream of you, the sweetest dream will ever do. I still miss you, babe. I don't wanna miss a thing. I don't wanna miss one sound. I don't wanna miss one kiss. I just want you to hear me.
Whoever threw that paper airplane dollar, you are fucking awesome.
all know who I am. I am the best damn deep sea oil driller in the world.
Heavy competition for deep sea oil drilling, by the way.
And I'm going to tell you this right now, Yuri. NASA has hired me to take out that asteroid. And I'm going to do it for the USA and also the rest of the world.
All right, and this matchup has begun.
And we are all fighting over a big red flag. Here, I got it. I got it. We're familiar.
Tossing Bruce Willis.
Oh, Yuri with a huge fucking charge like the Juggernaut, but gets shoved off by Bruce Willis. And Yuri with a quick arm drag. Drop down, but Yuri springs up to the second into another big arm drag. That's how they do arm drags in Mother Russia. It's at stake, but sure, USA. That's the important part.
USA.
Oh!
Oh, Bruce Willis calling out for the real Americans.
Broody Willis. Huge collar and elbow tie-up. Shoving Yuri back into the corner.
By the way, for the one pedantic asshole out there, his character's name is Harry Stamper, but come the fuck on, these people don't know that.
His name in every movie is Bruce Willis.
Hard yes. Hard yes.
You remember his name in Sin City? Yeah, it was Bruce Willis.
Oh yeah, what was his name in The Fifth Element?
Bruce Willis.
Oh, interesting. Interesting. What was his name in The Sixth Sense?
Oh shit, a test of strength with Bruce
it's a
Willis?
A test of strength sounds like it's Russia versus the USA to see who's stronger. Oh.
Built for tough.
Big Brucey is built for tough. Fort sponsored Armageddon, right? There were like money shots of Fort. That makes sense.
And now. We've gone from Russia to the USA, right into Greco-Roman knuckle lock. And Big Bruce, Bruce Almighty, showing the strength of those knuckles because he's on an oil rig all the time, so his hand gets a lot of working out there.
Deep sea oil drilling.
Yeah, yeah, that's...
Down, nothing happens.
Oh shit!
Oh, I don't, what? Who?
Ducks that clothesline. Oh, but catches!
Bruce Willis catches him though. Yeah, look at that. Slams him down America style.
Oh! And Bruce Willis with a big Irish whip. And a huge back elbow. A very proud American is Bruce Willis. As he was in that movie that his name was Bruce Willis. Die Hard? Yeah, it was Bruce Willis.
What about Die Hard 2?
Yep, also Bruce Willis.
What about Die Hard 3?
Samuel... No, Bruce Willis.
Oh, face first into the turnbuckle goes Bruce Willis.
Well, Bruce!
Soviet spacewalk, but gets stopped by Bruce Willis carrying him around. Side slam!
Uh-oh. And Bruce Willis has been on top of this. Bruce Willis pointing at the top turnbuckle, which means either he's going up to the top or he sees dead people. No!
Going for a double stomp, but no one was home.
And a huge flying cosmonaut clothesline. Into the pin, one, two, only two.
Gets him in the Siberian stretcher.
Oh, yeah. He's got him in that. Bruce Willis says no, who was also in the movie Unforgiven. I'm just digging deep into Bruce Willis movie knowledge.
Oh, what character did he play when he hosted SNL?
Yep.
Bruce Willis?
Yeah. Yeah. That one too. And now the cosmonaut, Yuri, taking Big Bruce all the way to the buckle. And Bruce is firing up. Oh, but rakes the eyeballs.
You dirty Ruski.
And now Yuri got him by the hand.
Notice his left hand.
Oh, whoa. I don't know how we do things in fucking Russia space. Holy shit! Ooh. And now Yuri ascending the ropes with the grace of a Russian cat. And now going into a moonwalk of sorts. Because space. Oh, shit! Oh,
the Russian tangled up on the ropes. Looks like you got him.
And Yuri, down on the cold floor of this space station that resembles the Oakland Metro Opera House.
Man, Bruce Willis is huge, easily stepping over that top rope.
Oh, he's very big. Oh, wait a second. And Ensign Wiggles is trying to get some control, but to no avail so far. Wow. But that time, it is Bruce Willis who eats the apron. Wait a second, no! Bruce Willis stops himself! Oh God, choking him! Choking the life out of that poor Russian cosmonaut!
Luckily, they're both astronauts, so they're very good at holding their breath.
That's true, that's how that works. And they are just... they are choking each other. Fun fact, Armageddon used to be my safe word.
I've never heard you say that.
You better believe it. I've got a lot of practice.
Oh, going outside the ring for Leica, it looks like.
Holy shit!
Distraction. Oh, Leica going up. Oh, both men down.
They both tried to catch the poor dog.
huge shot to the jaw, followed by another one which drops Bruce Willis. Unlike his movie Pulp Fiction, where he killed that guy by fisticuffs.
What character did he play in Pulp Fiction?
He was Bruce Willis. Oh shit! He's going for that Russian leg sweep! Nailed it. No!
Only two, says Ensign Wiggles.
And Bruce, up to his feet, from behind. Oh, shit! A brutal attack. One, two. Only two, says Ensign Wiggles. Wait a minute.
Bruce Willis pointing at Sputnik. The Russian satellite.
Bruce is going up top. Pulling down the Sputnik. Oh, shit!
Oh, Bruce almost brings Sputnik down with him.
Sputnik briefly coming out of orbit, but went back because it's full of helium, like a satellite. You know,
that is space. How satellites get into space.
I thought
fill them with helium.
Yeah, I remember that reading rainbow where I learned that. Yuri going for that superplex. Oh, God! Yuri runs into a huge Bruce boot. What? What is he doing? And a huge splash. One, two, no! Only two!
The Communist Party is alive and well in this matchup.
I thought that was it. They thought that was it, but only two. Oh shit, and Bruce is done fucking around here.
Yuri, I've been out here fighting you for the better part of a decade's worth of minutes. What in the hell is that? Tell me. Well, I am Bruce Willis, so it's not going to be hard to do that.
Oh! Oh, no! Choking the life out of Yuri.
Now, I'm going to give you one and one chance only. Tell me, what in the hell is that balloon thing that's not a balloon?
Sputnik is a bomb!
And oh my God, it's almost here!
Holy shit! Bruce Willis using his Bruce Willis vision to see through the space station, and that fucking asteroid's getting real close!
Mr. Shatner?
What? No, he's an ensign.
I think you better give me those special bomb scissors that aren't scissors that somehow got in your pocket.
Yes.
Detonators.
Oh, man. All of Starfleet has bomb scissors in their pockets. That's just Federation standard.
It's canon.
I think you two better get lost in the name of the US of A.
Oh, no. No, Bruce, you don't have to make this ultimate sacrifice. Oh, shit!
Bruce Willis has ridden Sputnik. He rode Sputnik and exploded it on the fucking asteroid. And Laika is still in the ring because they left that fucking dog in space.
Well, to be fair, the dog is
to be fair
from space. Well, Wonder Dave, I'm going to say the winner of this match, due to not blowing up, Yuri!
Yeah, that makes sense. He didn't die. Okay, fucking fine. The winner of this match was the friends we made along the way.
Jesus.
Laika is just riveting content for our Twitch stream right now. Anything you'd like to say to the crowd, Laika?
All right. Well, what do we have here? It looks like we have some kind of table set up, perhaps for some kind of interview segment. I wonder who in space could do some kind of interview. Let's find out.
Jason is here at Space Slam!
Hello, Mr. Space Guest.
Hello, Neil. We all have questions, and you have the answers.
That I do.
Well, let's cut to the chase, because on Space Ghost Coast to Coast, we ask the hard questions. Here at Space Slam, it's 2020, and these people want to know, when are we going to have flying cars?
Okay, that's a really good question. A lot of people have been asking me this. All right, I'm going to tell you a little story, okay? I'm going to tell you all a little story. Okay, so imagine yourself going down a straight line road. And to call that one dimension, okay? And if there's another vehicle, in front of you, you can only go as fast as he's going, actually. So you would think you would add a second dimension. Oh, you're lost. Well, you're not a quantum physicist like me, okay? Anyway,
so you just got to grasp Tyson.
A second dimension. You think that would,
sir? In all due respect, you're dodging the question.
I am not dodging the question.
These people want answers. Are we gonna have flying cars, or are we not?
You people already have flying cars. It's called helicopters and bridges and underground subway systems. Those are your flying cars. You people should know this.
Now, I don't know if you rode BART to get here, but if you parked in the same parking lot that I did, you would have saw my spaceship. Explain that.
You don't have a spaceship. And if you don't have the metallic alloy that you would take to go into the cosmos because there's so much radiation.
I'm fucking Space Ghost.
I'm a quantum physicist.
So the next thing you're going to tell me is that I didn't save the universe from the mantid race.
Mantis race?
It's preposterous.
It's preposterous. No, you did not do any of that.
So are you coming on my show and calling me a liar?
He is lying. He doesn't own a spaceship, okay? He doesn't travel the cosmoses. If he did, he would die.
Don't make me blast you.
Are you gonna try to blast me, huh? You don't have no phaser. Phasers aren't real. None of this is real. This is preposterous.
Was that foot real? How about these hands, you son of a bitch?
Space Ghost has decided to blast Neil deGrasse Tyson.
Are these hands fake?
Well, let's get...
Ensign Wiggles! Get out here!
That's right, looks like we've got ourselves a matchup. And...
Space Ghost!
Versus Neil deGrasse Tyson.
The match you never knew you always wanted. Oh! Right across the suit jacket comes a huge space forearm.
Space Ghost calling for a space splash, runs right into the turnbuckle.
And Neil deGrasse Tyson hits a huge flying back elbow, and the jacket comes off.
Hooks the leg.
Now, it's crucial to go for those early covers because it tires your opponent out. It's
oh, yes, it does.
Strategy.
The more you can pin your opponent, the more energy they have to use to keep kicking out.
Forearm to the back of Space Ghost.
And a poke to the eyeball. Takeover. Rolling through into a drop kick.
Only two, says Ensign Wiggles.
And
in a shocking turn of events, the crowd. Oh! Jesus Christ! Right in the asteroid belt.
Yep. A little below the asteroid belt. Uh-oh. Space Ghost scoop. And a slam.
Man, DeGrasse Tyson must really be feeling the gravity of this situation.
Oh, yeah. Here comes a big elbow. Right across the scientist. And again. Huge leg drop from Space Ghost. But again, only two. No, oh, nobody home. But a huge drop kick, and Neil deGrasse Tyson did not see that coming. Uh-oh, into a deep space chin lock. But Neil, trying to fight out. And this crowd has turned on Space Ghost for really no discernible reason. Fuck science, says the spaceman. And Neil, now back up to a vertical base. Oh! But gets slammed, gigantic brain first. Ugh, and a big thudding chop across the chest. And Neil quickly putting an elbow up.
Taken down by a clothesline. Quantum mechanics won't help you now, buddy.
No. No, did not have enough centrifugal force behind that.
Space Ghost charging up that arm.
Fucking plasma beam still is doing shit. Huge clothesline and a back elbow. Ducks that clothesline. Shot to the stomach. Oh, driving. Driving the leg into the back of the head.
Space Ghost looks like he got the elbow up at the last second.
Science, Space Ghost raking the eyeball. And a huge spinning space kick. Into the pin. But only two. And Neil deGrasse Tyson trying to make his way back up. Space Ghost waiting on him. Goes for another big spin kick. Oh, driving the knee right into the face.
Great ring awareness, pulls him away.
One, two, only two. Uh-oh. And Neil.
Oh, yeah.
It's serious now. No. And Neil deGrasse eats shit. Oh, my God. They have kicked his fucking mandible off of his skull. Got him hooked up. Into a big spine buster. Two, three, that is it.
All right.
Here is your winner, Space Ghost.
Chainsaw on Twitch is happy about Space Ghost's win, so
that's
one person. Hey, now seems like a great time to remind you that Hood Slam is here every fucking Friday, you guys!
That is a fact!
Now, folks, thus far, I'd say we've had a good time, right? I'd say this has been quite the wrestle show, wouldn't you? So we've had a good time. We've had a wrestle show. I just don't know if it's been sexy enough yet. What if we turn up the sexy just a little bit?
I like where your head's at. Well, luckily, not only did I bring Ensign Wiggles down from the Starship Enterprise, I also brought Jordy LaForge.
The sexiest man on the bridge of the Starship Enterprise. Beautiful humans, welcome to the ring, Jordy LaForge! Oh. Feel free to make those dollars fly if you like what you see. Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, Chat Noir!
One more time for Chat Noir, everyone!
We love Chat.
And for those who are interested in seeing more Chat Noir and I co-host an all-male review called Stroke. Our next show is February 22nd, and it's in a private place so we can get full nude. Now I'm going to pick up dollar bills in a very captivating manner.
Yeah, yeah. Get them. Get them with your cat paw. So while Wonder Dave is doing all that, we are here at the Oakland Metro Opera House every single fucking Friday. So if you ever run into a time where you're like, hey, what am I gonna do on a Friday night? Guess what's happening? Motherfucking Hood Slam! Our next show is right here, the first Friday of the month, and it is going to be fucking dope. The second Friday of the month is where we put women center stage for Guilty Lethal Action Mayhem Glam. And then we'll be right back here with a Hood Slam. And then the final Friday of the month is the Sexy Good Time Wrestle Show. So as I said, if you don't have anything to do on a Friday night, I just gave you something to do on that Friday night. Holy shit! Jet Noir as Jordy LaForge was fucking breathtaking. That shit was off the chain. So, with that in mind, let's go back to some wrestling silliness, shall we? All right, well, let's bring our next matchup out here right now.
Referee for this matchup, Ensign Wiggles!
Oh shit! I haven't seen him since Blood Slam! Ladies and gentlemen, this is the team of the Space Cowboys, Steve Miller and Maurice! These men are intergalactic bounty hunters. And Mardi Gras beads, Space Cowboy Steve Miller took my microphone.
He is hyped up tonight.
Only Maurice.
Maurice.
Maurice, relax. We need to show them our most recent bounty.
We got a bounty, Oakland. I said we have a motherfucking bounty! That's right! So, tell him about it! Oh my god! That is a fucking 24...
What?
24 karat... 24...
You dumb motherfucker, it's the Schwartz.
Oh shit! That's the fucking Schwartz ring? Uh-oh. Well, where there's Schwartz, There can be only one man coming to get it. Representing Spaceballs, this is
Lone Star.
Being distracted by Maurice on the outside. Oh, shit! Ring that bell!
And this matchup has begun.
And Space Cowboy Steve Miller is really laying it into Lone Star. Got that Schwartz ring. Oh! Lone Star ducks. And some huge canes right to the side of the face of that Space Cowboy. Irish whip, hard into the buckle. And Lone Star hitting a gigantic splash. Hold this till I need it, he says. And Lone Star driven face first into that space turnbuckle, which is harder than Earth turnbuckles. Huge punch right to the jaw. And Lone Star is on wobbly legs. Needs to get his space legs. Big elbow to the side of the face after that huge chop to the chest. Whoa, shit, look out!
By Lone Star.
Holy shit. Steve Miller really ate those fucking ropes. And Lone Star crowned him. No. What the fuck is Maurice doing?
Maurice says he's not doing anything.
And Lone Star's telling this crowd to get out of the way of that post. Irish whip gets reversed. And Lone Star meets that post in a way he probably didn't want to with his face.
Maybe he made a good impression.
Steve Miller slowly stalking his prey after pulling up those pants. No! Huge shot right to the head. And Lone Star is in a lot of trouble here. Oh! Huge boot to the face.
Right on the inside edge of the ring apron, which, as we all know, is the hardest part of the ring.
I mean, the posts are harder. Uh-oh. Could be going for a big neck breaker. Nailed it. And Steve Miller is down, and Lone Star is trying to go up. And drops the fist right into the face of that Space Cowboy. One, two, No, what the hell? What the hell, Maurice? Get out of there! Oh! You could hear the impact of that kick. And now Steve Miller hooking him up for a suplex. And Maurice enjoyed that one. And now Steve Miller dropping a huge robotic cybergenetic elbow, but only two. Maurice is flipping the fuck out. Huge shot. Irish whip gets reversed. Ducks the clothesline.
Oh.
And both men clothesline each other.
Maurice cannot believe it.
No, Maurice has fucking had just about enough of this shit. Both of these men have until a count of 10 to get back to their feet, or else this match is a draw. But both men are up.
Both men are up. And
another
double clothesline. Can you believe it?
Oh, the humanity. Maurice is trying to give that Schwartz ring to Steve Miller. But Miller is not going for it. Down again! Third time was not the charm for either man. Both men down again. And I don't know what it's going to take. Whoa, 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 whoa. Steve Miller thought better of that. And now, Steve Miller has that. Yeah, I don't know. But Steve Miller has that Schwartz ring. Putting it on, that means he can use the Schwartz. And he's got a handgun with the Schwartz. Oh my God. Oh, but that blast missed it. Missed it? Yeah, fuck you. That shot missed. Completely blasting a hole into the spaceship that we're in right now. Could be going for another one. Oh, but again, misses. And don't worry, I'm sure we'll be fine. We're not all gonna be sucked into the abyss of space or anything. Uh-oh, and now Lone Star stuck in a corner. Right where you don't wanna be. He's gonna get shot with that fucking space Schwartz gun. What the fuck? He's got a mirror. It hit the fucking cameraman.
I think he's dead. Oh, shit.
Shit, man. Are you getting
here to make the shit?
Yeah, that he dropped his hand 3 times. He's dead. That's science. Luckily, we have a replacement cameraman.
Yeah, we'll worry about this dead body later.
This feeling.
Oh, shit! Lone Star kicking that fucking cowboy in the dick! Use the Schwartz is right, he's got that ring! Oh! He's got him! He's got him with his Schwartz! No! Use the Schwartz to bitch slap a space cowboy! Which is a sentence I've always wanted to say. No! Tossing him around with his gigantic Schwartz.
His Schwartz is so big.
I see your Schwartz is as big as mine.
Oh, and sends him into the space buckles. And now, has him again, calling for it, bringing him in. He's got him up. Space cowboy out the back, ducks the Schwartz line, kicks him in the stomach. No! And drops him face forward, by God! And fucking Maurice. And he is all tied up. What the fuck? He's using the Schwartz! He's using, look at that levitating by itself! Look at the fucking, yeah, we'll edit this in post. Look at this fucking floating! Oh, just floated by! Into the hands of Lone Star! Oh, shit! Oh, my God! No!
Oh, Schwartz chin music!
1, 2, no! Oh, but now the Schwartz has fucking Maurice! And shit cans him out onto the stage! Oh shit! Huge lariat by a space cowboy! 1, 2, 3!
And your winner! The Space Cowboy!
Call. Who could this be? The
anticipation
is killing me. Shade. What? No, you're not a space cowboy.
Yes, it's a shame. It's a shame, is it?
I can explain. Hey.
Don't mind him.
I hear y'all. What does it take for me to be on the show as a cowboy? Do it right now.
Well, DeShade, it's like a space show. It's a space show where it's space slam.
I got lots of space.
No, you are like the opposite of space, man. Yeah, there's a costume here. I fucking got this from Starfleet or Amazon Prime, you know, one or the other. So you're just dressed as you. This is what you wear every day.
So I need a costume?
Yeah, you need a space costume. Space.
Oh, I got it. Hold this.
Holding it up.
Are you fucking shitting me? Yeah. No, man. DeShade has stickers of stars, and he's putting stars on his chest. And one on the nipple, yeah, of course. So this is a good time to, like, go to the drink, like, go take a piss, whatever you guys want to do. This might take a while for this spaceman to spaceify his space self. Ensign, does this look like the final frontier to you? Okay. You know what? Be on the show. Yeah, it's fine. Thank you. You've done enough. Yeah, go wrestle a space cowboy. I don't give a fuck. Ladies and gentlemen, once known as DeShade, is now, I don't know, DeSpace. So,
I would go with DeSpace. Listen.
However, DeSpace. Unfortunately, there was actually someone who was supposed to be in this match. So let's bring it out here!
Representing the Marvel Universe,
a being that fought the Celestials! And live to tell the tale! The physical manifestation of space and time itself! This is Eternity! Holy shit! Now that's how you put fucking stars all over your body!
Oh,
making its way into the ring on its own time, because eternity takes a while. And Steve Miller dragging that poor dead cameraman out of the ring. And it looks like Steve Miller may be joining us for commentary.
No, I'm pretending I'm dead.
Okay. And Ensign Wiggles is looking straight into the eyes of eternity, which sounds way deeper and metaphorical than I meant it to sound.
I find this strangely erotic.
Fun fact, if Wiggles pisses himself, it just recycles it in the spacesuit.
Oh, the future.
Well, this was supposed to be a one-on-one match, but we have ourselves a triple threat here. Eternity versus Maurice the Space Cowboy and Deshade.
Da Star. Oh. Oh, it's still a sexy good time, I see. All right.
And this one is underway. Oh, my God. Eternity just punched the fucking star's lights out. Huge shot from Eternity. Irish whip gets reversed, but Eternity up and over. And another big shot. Oh, and a huge enziguri to the back of that Space Cowboy's cranium.
Eternity seems to be dominating early in this matchup.
Oh! Another big shot to the jawbone. Ducks the back elbow. Sunset flip. Eternity says no.
Oh,
and a huge double, Jesus. And a kick to the head by the Space Cowboy. And another kick to the head. Fuck you, Maurice. Eternity calling for silence. Oh! And a huge shot reverberating throughout the Oakland Metro Space Station. Oh, no. Oh, gross.
God damn it. Now he's going to have to go back to Party City where he belongs.
Oh, no! Eternity! Eternity biting the finger of that fucking Space Cowboy!
This match has been all Eternity all the time. Oh, the star.
And that might be what it takes, is some teamwork. Double Irish whip.
That's motherfucking teamwork.
No. Okay.
No. We turn.
And Oh, what is Eternity doing here? What is this?
Looks like he's going for it. Oh, yeah. Can he get them both up? Oh, no!
Oh, shit! That backfired. Steve Miller just informed me that was all Maurice. Huge belly-to-belly from Maurice to Eternity. And the star just hits a fucking huge leg drop. And now, tossing Eternity to the outside. And the star really, really getting at it. Oh, man! A couple of huge shots knocking the hair out of the eyeball of fucking Maurice. Ducks a clothesline and a huge boot. And another huge belly to belly. And now riding the star like a space cowboy would do.
Sexy Good Time Wrestle Show.
Into the pin, one, two, only two, says Ensign Wiggles. And now Maurice heading to the outside. No, but gets caught with a huge forearm shot and a kick right to the face. And now Eternity, right behind the star. And the star's like, you know what? Nah, I'm gonna walk around Eternity. Because that's how time and time travel works. Huge punch. Return. Oh my God! Didn't you hear that? Okay. Irish whip.
The star winds up and stopped in his sexy, sexy tracks.
Oh, God! And Eternity is just fucking it. Oh, shit. Remember what I said at the beginning? Watch the fuck out!
Suicide dive through the ropes. Eternity says not enough and goes for it again.
Could be going for all three. Off the ropes. Holy shit. Could not be avoided, that fucking intergalactic dive. This is as real as it fucking gets, folks. And the star trying to make his way back to his feet, hooked in a waist lock, throws an elbow. Couple connect, ducks under, into a go behind, but Eternity with a go behind. And another big elbow. Oh, shit! A huge forearm right to the nape of the neck. Irish whip gets reversed. And the star trying to make what comeback he can. Oh, and a huge fucking splash. Irish whip into the far side. Oh my God!
Fuck Maurice.
Maurice may be out on his fucking space feet. And a huge knee strike from Eterno. Uh-oh, watch out. Double stomp. And a big German suplex by the Space Cowboy. Space Cowboy. Space Cowboy. Jesus Christ. Maurice could be going up for that big bonsai drop. But he gets kicked right in the fucking space face. And Maurice eating the turnbuckle repeatedly. And now getting dragged upward. What is oh, shit. Whoa! And down he goes. And DeStar. Jesus Christ! And a fucking leg drop of all things. Maurice is fucking down and could be out. Two. No, only two. And caught Eternity on the ropes. And now DeStar is heading up, possibly for a fucking superplex. Oh shit! Maurice got him in a powerbomb! Jesus! Can Maurice capitalize? One, two, no! How on earth, or any other planet for that matter, is this match still going on?
I do not know.
And Maurice, the only entity standing, well, never mind. Lost it as it was coming out of my mouth.
And huge shots to the face of Eternity.
Jesus! Watch out! Oh my God!
Brutally kicking Maurice out of the ring.
And DeStar is not where you want to be with Eternity staring you down.
Fuck you, says DeStar.
Jesus! What a huge fucking clothesline. Splits! And hits a big fucking wheel kick right to the head. One, two, no! Only two, says Ensign Wiggles. And DeStar trying to think of what else to do, going instead, leaving Eternity behind and pulling in Maurice.
I'd say that's the wiser decision in a three-way matchup. Gets him up.
Oh, wow. Just got his fucking attitude adjusted. One. No, and a double stomp right across the lower back of that Space Cowboy.
That's right. Mike, this is a three-way matchup, meaning you don't have to be pinned to lose. First person to attain a pinfall or submission wins.
Eternity is trying to knock Maurice unconscious here. Hits the ropes. And a big boot to the side of Eternity's face, followed by a slap. And a boot returned. Watch out! Jesus! Oh my God! Night, night, motherfucker! Holy shit! The Star trying to steal one real quick! Kick to the stomach! Kicks Eternity up! And a big fucking Lariato! And now, the Star setting Eternity up precariously on the top turnbuckle. Could be going for that big superplex again. But Eternity fighting out into a gourd buster. Oh shit. Eternity. Eternity up top. Oh my God! That's gotta be it! 2, 3!
And your winner, Eternity!
Holy shit, what a fucking match! And I'm sure that the Star will go back to being DeShade and then regret every decision that led him to this place.
Fucking chaos left in this ring here. You did a number on them. All of these people came here tonight to see fucking Space Slam, and you, sir, represent space in and of itself. Is there anything that you would like to say to these people, probably with profanity in it?
Do you motherfuckers want to see me lick his fucking face? don't think you fucking heard me. I asked, do you motherfuckers want to see me lick his face?
Sometimes in life, you gotta take your licks, buddy.
You know what's weird about that man's tongue is it's gritty like a fucking cat's tongue. What do you eat besides my asshole, man? Come on. Hashtag butt stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, pretty good in defeat themselves, Da Star and Fuck You Maurice.
Well, have you folks had a sexy good time at this wrestle show? Yeah, I do believe we should cue some music right now to continue this sexy good time, right?
Because at the end of every sexy good time wrestle show, we have to end it with a sexy dance party!
Oh, yeah.
Oh, shit. Maurice is getting it. But the star looks somewhat unimpressed here.
The star ready to show off his sexy good time moves.
Oh, shit!
Jiggle, jiggle, it's a party in the middle.
Oh,
bullies.
Man, and we're having a sexy good time, because here comes Yuri! And Sputnik 2. And if you ever wanted to see a Russian cosmonaut dance, you're welcome. Here he comes, graceful as a one-legged cat. What do you say, Da Star? On a scale of 1 to 5. Yeah. A 4. Oh, whoa. No. Put that down. Don't ruin this sexy good time.
The space cowboy's got like the dog.
All right. We're leaving the dog. No, we're leaving the dog alone. Oh, and Sputnik is loose! No, fuck!
Oh, no!
Jesus Christ! And he's okay!
Ah, oh, what a good girl. Flip off the top rope, it's hard to master.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for coming to Sexy Good Time Wrestle Show presents Space Slam!
Please join join us again next month when Sexy Good Time Wrestle Show gets femmed out. That's right, it's our annual show where we encourage the wrestlers and you, the audience, to get femmed the fuck out.
Hell yes, our yearly tradition that has been going on even longer than Sexy Good Time Wrestle Show. You are going to see some beautiful women that may be men in drag, but you are also going to see some beautiful women wrestling their fucking asses off, and it's going to be fantastic. Fun fact about Femmed Out, I met my girlfriend at Femmed Out. I was dressed as Dorothy Gale from The Wizard of Oz. Hey. She saw one look at that and was like, this ain't Kansas anymore, Toto. I don't know what that means.
Listen, badass.
Thank you all so much for coming. This has been Sexy Good Time Wrestle Show. Stop by your merchandise table. I have been Anton Luke Picard.
I have been Wonder Dave Mancat.
Hell yeah. Drive safely.
Good night.
Get home safe.